This is your AESH Electric Energy News Minute for Tuesday, April 20, 2021. In mainstream news, CNBC reports, Danish energy giant Ørsted is pivoting to onshore wind in new $684 million deal. Ørsted said Friday it had reached an agreement with Brookfield Renewable to purchase a 100% equity interest in the latter's Irish and UK onshore wind business, Brookfield Renewable Ireland. According to Ørsted, the agreement has an enterprise valuation of €571 million, $684 million, although this figure is subject to adjustments. The deal is slated to close in the second quarter of 2021. Bloomberg headline, Pakistan to rein in $14 billion government owes to energy firms. Pakistan is finalizing a plan to address about 2.2 trillion rupees, $14.4 billion, of debt the government owes to the energy sector, a liability that's doubled in the past 2 years as power purchases outstripped demand. Islamabad aims to pay 400 billion rupees in late fees to several electricity producers by June in a deal to cut power costs, and will ask banks to restructure the remaining debt, according to Tabish Gahar, special assistant to Prime Minister Imran Khan for the energy sector. The Financial Times reports, lithium miners and $3.1 billion merger as electric vehicles fuel demand. Wall Street Journal headline, General Motors to help build $2.3 billion battery cell plant in Tennessee. General Motors Company and joint venture partner LG Chem Limited plan to invest $2.3 billion to construct a second battery cell plant to support the Detroit automaker's efforts to expand its electric vehicles portfolio. General Motors and LG said construction on the roughly 2.8 million square foot facility in Tennessee will begin soon, with its opening slated for late 2023. It will supply battery cells to General Motors' Spring Hill assembly plant. Forbes headline, Tesla faces speed bumps as it takes first steps into India's nascent electric vehicle market, analysts warn. Tesla has finally taken some concrete steps to enter the vast Indian market, yet the e-vehicle giant must now navigate an inefficient and corrupt political system, the nation's lack of battery charging infrastructure and immense poverty that would make its cars affordable only to a tiny elite, analysts warn. BBC reports, deep sea mining to help make electric vehicles. As the world begins to move away from petrol and diesel power cars, there are questions over how the metals needed for batteries in electric vehicles will be sourced. One possibility is to mine the deep ocean floor. A number of companies are lining up to exploit the minerals found there, but campaigners warn it could have a disastrous impact on the marine environment. EnergyLiveNews.com reports, New York announces $25 million to boost energy efficiency in commercial buildings. Funding worth $25 million, £18.2 million, has been announced to boost the energy efficiency and reduce greenhouse gas emissions in commercial buildings in New York. The Real-Time Energy Management, RTEM, Plus Tenants program will support replicable approaches for commercial office buildings to cost-effectively reduce energy consumption. It will offer a 33% project cost share to solution providers, with a maximum of $400,000, £290,764, per project. PowerGrid.com reports, Pacific Gas and Electric Company leading new microgrid projects for mission-critical vulnerable customers. Pacific Gas and Electric Company has launched its community microgrid program and already started work on the first major project in the effort. The California Public Utilities Commission approved Pacific Gas and Electric's Community Microgrid Enablement Program, CMEP, last month. The utility will provide technical and financial support for qualifying projects in areas with the greatest resiliency needs, according to the release. This will include dedicated funding to help meet the resilience needs of disadvantaged and vulnerable communities, Pacific Gas and Electric said. This has been your AESH Electric Energy News Minute for April 20, 2021. If you want more global electric energy news and real-time alerts, hit the subscribe button now and follow us on social media.